Eric, it is time.
What are you going?
It's your house.
Yeah, it's your house.
Listen to them in there. The party has reached its critical mass. In 10 minutes' time, there will be no more beer theft opportunities.
Yes, but if my dad catches me nicking booze, he will kill me.
Eric, I'm willing to take that risk.
I mean, just don't worry about it. Just stay cool and keep moving.
No snacks, no small talk.
Oh, and above all, don't get sucked into my dad's hair.
No snacking, no talking, no sucking.
What's wrong with your dad's hair?
Just don't look at it.
Oh, Eric, remember, shandy doesn't count.
Yeah. Actually, you know, shandy makes me randy.
Maguire, anything makes you randy. Yeah, and Jackie's not here, so don't look at me, all right? Hello, Eric.
Hi, Eric.
Hi, Eric. Hi, Eric. Make way for the cheesy pineapple hedgehogs.
Yummy.
Pineapple is so versatile, isn't it? It makes everything taste exotic, doesn't it?
Hello there, Eric.
Mr. Palmer.
So, Eric, what do you think of Bob's new hair then, eh? Isn't it groovy?
Oh, it's incredibly groovy, Mrs. Palmer.
It was Midge's idea.
It's a perm.
Cool.
Your dad?
What the hell's happened to Bob's hair?
Don't ask me.
His head looks like a poodle's arse. Just when you think you've seen everything.
Yeah, poodle's arse walks into your party.
Eric, don't say the arse word in my house. You're still at school.
Sixth form college, Dad.
Bob's coming through!
Kitty, is that your Toyota in the drive outside?
Ron, a Toyota?
Yeah, it's mine. We spent hard-earned cash on a second-hand rice burner.
Oh, Ron.
They're so economical.
Last time I was that close to a Japanese machine, it was shooting at me.
Even with your hours cut back, you have to have a car. The Zephyr never started.
Those sods at the garage said they'd only take it for scrap.
They're sharks.
That Zephyr can rust in the drive before I let them have it.
Ron, it is rusting in the drive.
Try to tell me no one wants British-made cars anymore.
Well, we didn't want one.
Yeah, I know, but I make them. I know what goes on. If I didn't, I'd be as patriotic as the next man.
I could be the next man, Dad.
But I'm patriotic. Maybe I could take on a Zephyr and, you know, get her going.
What have you got there, Eric?
A beer. I found it. Lying around.
Put him away, son.
Oh, I intend to put them away.
Sweetheart, could you do me a favour? Could you put those in the freezer on your way to the garage? They're warm. Right. I feel like a song with actions. Ron, where's that Wurzels LP?
Who are?
Hey, take a look at them.
I see that every day, boys. Well, almost.
Cha-ching! He's alive! Oh. Good news, my dad's made me think of giving me the Zephyr.
What, you get in the car?
Oh, have I ever told you how incredibly attractive you are, Eric?
Yeah, but you've sold me.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, I remember. You said not to say anything to Eric.
Hey, let's remember what's important here, folks. Eric stole something! To Eric the Ninja Foreman.
To Eric!
Do you know what's sad? This is the proudest day of my life.
Thank you so much. much for saving me from the Daleks again. I'm such a helpless idiot.
Stop talking, Sarah-Jane, and keep jiggling up and down that jumpsuit.
Oh, Doctor, I need to give me your sonic screwdriver, quick!
Bodygate! Bodygate!
Michael, why are we watching this without sound? I am totally confused.
Use the earpiece.
So, Eric, how are negotiations going with your old man about the car?
Fine. Apart from he's never mentioned it again.
Shush.
Well, why don't you ask him?
And feel the wrath of Ron.
Yeah, then how do we get to the concert?
Shh. What concert?
Steve Hartley and Cockney Rebel.
When?
It's this weekend.
Oh, and who's going?
Well, it's Eric and Donna and Gio Bjorn, that foreign lad, and me, Dylan. Oh, pretty much everyone. And you.
Oh, good, good, good. Thank you for telling me, Michael.
Well, sitting here is thirsty work. Anybody for a glass of squash?
Oh, yeah, me.
You sit down. I'll get yours. You don't want me to go to the concert, is that it?
No, I didn't think you liked music.
Michael, of course I like music. You've seen the stickers on my pencil case.
Well, I didn't ask you to the concert because I know you don't like my friends.
Oh, and did you tell them that?
No.
Michael, don't tell other people our private conversations. See, we have to have our own private conversations, Michael.
Well, and I didn't think you liked Cockney Rebel. I mean, like you said, they're no Bay City Rollers.
I like Cockney Rebel. I've got their 45 have come up and see me. You remember the night I got it?
Yeah.
We had fun that night, didn't we, Michael?
Yeah.
Well, we could have fun at the concert, especially in the car on the way back.
Why don't you come?
Oh, well, only if you want me to.
No, I want you to.
So, Jackie, I suppose you're coming to the concert with us.
Yep, and I can't wait. So, Michael, do you want to come back to mine and listen to Cockney Rebel records?
Oh, yes, please.
You kids have fun now.
Bye-bye. Oh, they're so adorable. The minute you turn your backs, they'll be humping little bunny rabbits.
Yeah, they are frisky.
Can't leave them alone for a second.
You know, my sister doesn't think that, that we should be left alone together.
Us? Well, we're alone now.
Yes, we are. No doubt about that.
Eric, relax. We've lived next door to each other since time began. You could have had me when I was 4.
Really? And there I was every day seeing how high I could get on my pogo stick. Excuse me.
Stupid.
Ever since yesterday, I can't stop thinking about you. I've known you practically my whole life, but up until now, it never seemed possible. But now it feels so close, I can feel it. I want you. Oh, I really want you. You know, I think I actually love you.
Eric, it's a car.
I think we should leave these two alone together.
Hi, Donna.
Hi, Dad.
Oh, you youngsters standing around by the road. Well, it's just so sweet. You may not realise it, but this is the best time you're ever going to have.
So it's all downhill from here on, is it, Mr. Palmer?
That's right, yeah.
What happened to your dad, sir?
He got a perm.
Yeah, as in permanent wave.
What, that's permanent? Yeah. Nice.
Naff?
I may not say this right because I'm new to English, but she has tremendous breasts, yes?
Michael, who is that boy?
Oh, that's Torbjorn Rasmussen. Oh, he's new this term. I mean, Eric thinks he's cool.
Is he foreign?
Torbjorn Rasmussen, foreign. I can't believe it.
Donna, I have to go to the ladies. Donna!
I too much visit the lavatory. Eric.
It doesn't work the same way with boys.
Maguire, how long do you estimate we're going to have to put up with this whole Jackie experience?
Don't worry about it, I'm dumping her.
Highly unlikely.
No, I am. Yeah, she's cramping my style.
Yeah, quick impression for you. Jackie, you.
Jackie, why do you bring me along every time you go to the loo? Are you scared you're going to fall in?
Donna, I know you don't like me.
Who said?
I've sensed it for a long time. You know, you're hard.
Look who's talking.
I'm not hard. Daddy says I'm a pussycat.
Well, I suppose he's half right. Look, we're just different, that's all.
Well, I'm a lot like my mother.
She competitive too, then?
No, she's pretty.
You're always competing against other women for male attention.
So?
So I don't think male approval makes you a better person.
Well, it can get you what you want.
Well, I don't want anything that much.
Oh, really? Well, I can think of something. Eric?
We're just friends.
Oh, he's quite cute, but I wouldn't go out with him.
Well, he's not your type, is he? He's honest and sensitive.
Michael's honest and sensitive.
Yeah, but at least Eric speaks in proper sentences.
Well, if you think Eric's so great, why don't you make a move for him?
Well, I... just... yeah.
Nice sentence. You should be dancing! You should be dancing!
So is Ron still thinking about giving you the car, maybe?
Even if we do get the car, I mean, we're going to need a lot of petrol money, because, you know, big cars, they're thirsty.
Yeah, and the Zephyr's as big as a boat.
Who's getting a boat?
We shouldn't even need petrol, man. I heard about this bloke who invented a car that runs on water. It's got a fiberglass air-cooled engine, and it runs on water.
So it is a boat?
No, it's a car. But the petrol company's covered it up. They control everything.
I've never even heard of this car, you know? I mean, I could ask Jackie for petrol money.
Maguire, you are such a...
Maguire is a whore. Every time you got one customer.
I'm no whore.
Yeah, I suppose you only go out with Jackie for the conversation.
In my country, a whore is somebody who gets money for having sex.
I think that's pretty conclusive, Maguire.
When does the boat get here, whore?
I want to talk to you.
Eric, your mother and I have been talking about the car.
You've been talking to the car?
About the car. Since I've been cut back to part-time and a hospital so close, I can take the Toyota to work and your mum can take the bus.
Oh, Ronnie, I'd rather walk. When I take the bus in my nurse's uniform, people always try to show me their scars.
Well, then I'll drop you off on the way to the factory.
I don't want to be any trouble.
Well, Eric can't drop you off. He'll probably never even get the Zephyr going.
Well, if it's that broken down, should we let him have it at all?
Well, he asked for it.
Excuse me, am I getting the car?
We didn't say that. Things don't just drop into your lap, Eric, not in this life.
A car is a responsibility.
You'll need insurance. Have you any idea how much insurance is?
A car is a privilege.
Oil changes, radiator water, all the fluids, keeping them topped up.
A car is not a bedroom on wheels.
Always give way to oncoming traffic. Always.
Helen's friend got pregnant in a car. Don't let that happen.
And if I find one beer bottle in that car, it's over.
I know jam donuts. Ants.
Am I getting the car?
your mother.
Sorry. Thanks, Dad.
Yeah, well. Clean the attic.
That's sweet.
No, actually, I'm taking pole position.
No, you're not.
I'm not sitting in the back.
Fine. It says ask Eric.
All right, Eric.
Maguire.
Get in the back.
Taking her for a spin, eh?
Yes, Dad.
Oh, one more thing, very important about the car. I know you've got it going again, but it's still an old banger, so no trips outside Luton. Ever.
Well, that's that. We're not going.
Eric, do you want to go?
Yeah, but he said no trips outside town.
You're sitting behind the wheel. You've got Cockney Rebel tickets in your pocket. Do you want to go or not?
Yes, but he's God.
God won't find out.
No, God finds out everything.
Eric, he doesn't own you.
No, God would want us to go to Cockney Rebel.
Eric, you are your own man. We will abide by whatever you say. It's your decision.
Yeah, it is my decision. My decision is, we're going to the concert.
Yeah!
The kids are off. Wonder where they're going.
Out of town.
Are you sure?
Of course, I told them not to.
Be gone for quite some while then.
Yeah. Come on, love.
I'm telling you, we've run out of petrol.
It's the battery.
Yeah, what would you know? You're a girl. I mean, the tanks run dry and the pump sucked in the dirty residue.
It's the battery. Some cowboy's ripped out your wiper motor.
I know what, I'll call my daddy.
Maguire, tell her.
Yeah, you can't take the car out of Luton.
I'm not calling his dad.
Jackie, parents talk to each other about the ways we screw up.
And why would they want to talk about that?
Look, they can't help it. Imagine there's a party, and my mum comes in and says to Jackie's dad,
oh, Folly Barn's coming through!
Hello, Mrs. Foreman. I say, isn't it great that all our children are such tremendous pals?
Yes, Jackie's dad. They're quite the gang of young people.
Kitty, I just adore what you've done with the kitchen.
Yes, Acker and Lemon. They're such fun, aren't they? Blah, blah, blah.
Speaking of our children, wasn't it fortunate that I saved young Eric when he took your car to London against your specifically declared wishes?
What? Why, that twisted little monkey. Now I've found that out by total chance, I'm really gonna make him pay.
Children, what can you do?
I say we torture them with years of pointless rules and foolish advice.
Come on, everybody, let's do the hustle! No, just stop it! I'm stuck in the middle of nowhere and I have to go to the ladies. Donna?
Okay, but I warn you, this time I actually need a pee.
So, where are you kids going?
Cockney Rebel.
Hey, cool. Yeah. But not without a battery. I'll get you a battery.
Are they cheap or possibly free?
£12.50 minimum.
I'll tell you what, we'll sort you our battery plus £5 for one of your batteries.
That is an uncommonly sweet deal you're offering me, my friend, but I'll tell you what, one battery for two Cockney Rebel tickets.
Oh, no, we can't give up two tickets.
Fair enough.
Well, it's either that or none of us go.
Yeah, but who's out?
Well, there's Jackie.
Yeah, I mean, Jackie's as good as gone, but I mean, who else?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe Jackie's boyfriend.
You know what I'm finishing with her? You guys are giving me the dry ump.
I had to listen to her for a good hour.
A really long hour.
God hates me.
How can you say God hates you? At least you have a woman's love. Be happy, whore. This suit is for leisure, but many times I use it to get down to business. Doug's girlfriend is a man.
That's okay.
We are so cool to be okay about that. What you
say? I need to go to the toilet. Kevin. I'll explain later.
This isn't working.
No, it's a Boy Scout belt.
No, I feel funny.
No, you don't. You feel silky.
Michael, will you speak? Please hear my words. I think we should break up.
What? No.
You're not having a good time.
No, I'm having a good time.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, Michael, I'm so glad you don't want to split up. It was so nice to give away your tickets so that you could be with me.
Well, yeah.
It says that you don't need music and concerts and friends. You know what you need.
No.
Me. You need me, 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 me. You need me, Michael.
Well, I suppose.
You're just too shy to say that. This is much more fun than Cockney Rouble, isn't it, Michael?
Oh, yeah.
Great night. It's amazing what one act of civil disobedience can do for you. There's a whole world just waiting to be driven to. We could go to Wales. What's stopping us?
Actually, I think Wales closes at 9:30.
You know, I probably would never have driven to the concert if you hadn't talked me into it.
I didn't talk you into anything. Well, I'm going to call it a day. So good night.
Good night.
And by the way, thanks for the lift.
What was that for?
I just wanted to see what it was like.
What was it like?
You were there too.
I wasn't ready for it.
So what would you have done differently?
I don't know. Something with my lips, maybe?
That sounds nice. We'll try that next time.
When exactly is next time?
Good night.
Yeah. Like I'm gonna sleep after that.